Good morning, good evening, good night, whenever you're watching this video. My name is Aaron, Christatic AJ as always, and at the time of this recording, this video just came out 6 hours ago. It's an exclusive clip from PlayStation, from Across the Spider-Verse, because, you know, PlayStation, Sony, Spider-Man, right? So I'm going to give this a look, give you my thoughts on it, and my thoughts on the movie itself, like, as it's coming out soon, what I think it's going to do, and I'm seeing it Friday, so I'm excited about that. But yeah, let's give this a look-see, see what they're doing.
Excuse me, do you have an ATM machine?
Yeah, around here in the box.
Preferably not chained to the wall.
What?
Nothing.
This should be simple enough. Just make a hole, grab the money. Oh, that's not right. Just get the...
Give me your money.
Where are you, money? Where are you?
Give me...
Hey, who left this ATM on the sidewalk?
Yo, what you doing back there, man?
Nothing, nothing. Everything's cool, man. All good. Just forgot my PIN number.
Get your cell phone up here.
No, sir, please, just let me rob you.
I'm going to rob you.
There's no reason to bring wood into this. I've never robbed anybody in my life. Please don't make this a bad experience for me.
Bad experience? I'm trying to run a business here.
I have this whole...
Oh, wow, is this curry powder?
Well, see, I'm a scientist. I was. I am.
Anyway,
you've heard of Alchemax? I used to work there. I was actually considered handsome by scientist standards. I had a little accident. Ah! Now look at me. I'm so sorry. First of all, I'm not even robbing you. I mean, this ATM machine doesn't even belong to you, right? This belongs to the bank. They're the real criminals.
You're the real criminal. You're robbing me.
You know, I can't really get a job anywhere anymore being like this, so I've turned to a life of crime. I'm having
trouble. Why do people say ATM machine?
Who said that?
The M stands for machine.
Spider!
That was cool. That was a little interesting spot, I guess. Yeah. That was cool. So the movie, I think it's going to make a bunch of money just off of the previous audience it garnered from Into the Spider-Verse. I think that there's a huge audience there that actually grew after the movie came out. You know, I don't think many people were, you know, hip to it when it was in theaters, but after the fact, people kind of got... kind of put on to what this movie was and how great it was, and, you know, the acclaim and everything kind of came after the fact. Oscar winning film, you know, all type of stuff. And so it has garnered a fan base that I think is going to make it a huge contender in the box office. As far as the film itself, I think it's gonna be good. I don't know if it's going to beat the original film, just because, again, I think a film like that does come only like once every so many years. I mean, to have everything come together like it did, you know, it's always hard to have fire strike twice, or however that saying goes. It's hard to, you know, make sequels and make them better than the original, especially when the original has set the bar so high. And so I'm not expecting it to beat Into the Spider-Verse, but I am expecting it to take Miles' story forward and to have a whole bunch of Easter eggs and, like, hints and things for the fans of Spider-Man, which I am. So I'm trying to catch all of those. But yeah, I think it's going to do well. Mainly what I wanted to do is just continue Miles' story and be a good written story first with good characters. I think that one of the things killing modern movies is the political leanings and, like, the agendas going into films nowadays. I think it's just extra. We don't need it, especially when you can get your message across through just a poignant story. I think that's what we've been doing for years, and that's why we have films we love that, you know, weren't political in nature innately. They were just good stories, and, you know, to be able to learn stuff, you know, by being able to form our own opinions and kind of receive, you know, through watching people go through stuff and be people, or, you know, be whatever they are. Good stories should come first before, you know, agendas and things like that. And so I'm hoping that Because again, the first one came out in 2018. I think the post 2020, you saw a lot of this stuff happen. So hopefully, you know, hopefully, this movie does not get bogged down by any of that. And it can just be a good Spider-Man film. Into the Spider-Verse is, I think, the best Spider-Man film that we've had so far. And so I'm excited to see these characters that they've, you know, created done justice in the sequel. The filmmaker in me is really going to be like, you know, watching this movie intently. I'm going to be out your way. Peace and deuces.